The Moon, the natural satellite of the Earth, is the only celestial object ever visited by humanity. Between 1969 and 1972, 12 people were taken to the Moon's surface under 6 Apollo mission flights. The first humans to visit the Moon were the Moon astronauts Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin. Gene Cernan and Harrison Schmitt performed the longest walk on the Moon during the last Apollo flight. But what all these people have in common is that they all had to wear a spacesuit that weighed 91 kilograms on Earth. But why do you have to wear a spacesuit? And what if you don't? How long can you survive on the Moon without a suit? Hey guys, welcome back to Discover X. Today we'll be looking at how important it is to wear a spacesuit outside your shuttle and how long you can survive without one. Spacesuits are specially designed space equipment to protect your body from the harmful rays and temperature of outer space and to maintain the body's pressure while in vacuum or varied pressure. The A7L spacesuit designed for the Apollo program cost $100,000. That would be around $600,000 today. However, today they are one of the most expensive pieces of equipment used in space exploration. The exact cost to replace a spacesuit is unknown, but estimates range as high as $250 million. For the remaining 11 suits, the damage is mounting, with 7 in various stages of refurbishment and maintenance. That only leaves 4 flight-ready spacesuits aboard the International Space Station. But why are those suits so important? Suits are not just the work clothes, they're more like human-shaped spacecraft. It all has the things you need to survive for a particular amount of time, depending on the suit's facility. You'll find some extra knowledge about suits at the end of this episode. But what if you find yourself on the surface of the Moon without a spacesuit or any other protective equipment? The Moon does not have an atmosphere and therefore no free oxygen for breathing. It would only be a matter of minutes until you would die of severe asphyxiation. Asphyxia is the condition when your body doesn't get enough oxygen to perform cellular respiration. In this condition, you may lose consciousness in 30 to 180 seconds. In 1 minute, your brain cells start to die, and by the next 2 minutes, the neurons would have suffered extensive and permanent damage. In 5 minutes, death comes to be close. In 10 minutes, even if the brain cells are alive, you enter a coma. As more time passes, and by the 15 minutes mark, survival becomes nearly impossible. But that's not the only thing you need to be worried about. There are other ways in which you could die before that. Since the Moon is surrounded by nothing but a vacuum, there is no air pressure. This means the pressure acting is extremely low. On Earth, a column of air mass 15 to 20 tons presses the entire surface of an adult body, but we don't feel this pressure due to the air pressure inside our bodies. The inner pressure balances out the pressure acting on our bodies. When the pressure acting on our body is low, the cells leave out the dissolved nitrogen molecules as air bubbles. This causes the body to swell up. But don't worry, you won't burst into pieces yet. Luckily, the human skin is elastic enough to hold the insides inside. But you will swell up like a space balloon. This condition is called ebullism. This can cause you to look like an ugly space human balloon. And don't even think about holding your breath. Even when there is no oxygen to breathe, clear out your lungs. Holding your breath will only make things worse. When you hold your breath, the air inside your lungs will increase the relative pressure inside your lungs compared to the surrounding space. This can cause the lung to burst inside the body. This is the same situation as scuba divers. If they rise to the surface too fast, the air pressure inside their lungs will be too high and their lungs would burst. Even if you manage to survive with all this, there are other things to worry about. The surface of the Moon is filled with craters due to constant collisions with asteroids. These collisions leave debris so fine and sharp as glass called regolith, which, if inhaled, can cause internal injury and bleeding. Although the dust is mostly silica and non-poisonous, these particles can cause eye irritation, and severe lung disease is known as silicosis. This disease was discovered on Earth as the reason that many miners died years after drilling. Silicosis is where the tiny particles are so small that it gets into the very deepest part of the lungs and cannot be caught out. The white blood cells of the immune system cluster around the particles, and the victim eventually dies as the lungs become more and more ineffective. Also, because of the lack of atmosphere, the temperature on the Moon's surface is highly varying. Daytime on one side of the Moon lasts about 13 and a half days, followed by 13 and a half nights of darkness. When sunlight hits the moon's surface, the temperature can reach 260 degrees Fahrenheit, 127 degrees Celsius. When the sun goes down, temperatures can dip to minus 280 Fahrenheit, minus 173 Celsius. These are extreme temperatures the human body cannot withstand. But since there is no air or wind, there are only two possible heat transfer methods, conduction and radiation. Since the moon's surface is not conductive, it takes a good time to transfer the heat to the human body. When it does, you'll feel the saliva inside your mouth boiling. The exposed moisture will evaporate even from your eyes. Your heat does not transfer through convection due to a lack of flowing air or through another medium. But radiations directly from the sun is another threat. These radiations are deadly, and direct contact on the skin can cause severe burns. At certain times, the sun also emits large wavelength X-rays and gamma rays that would easily cause death in seconds. And since the moon has a weak magnetic field, you will also be stricken by solar and galactic cosmic rays that will cause serious health issues in the future if you survive. If ever abandoned on the moon's surface without a suit or similar equipment, all you can do is send a signal to get help because the rest is not in your hands. Ever since the Apollo program, there has been a remarkable improvement in spacesuit designs and utility. As an add-on for today's episode, we'll also be looking at spacesuits and the different types of suits. A spacesuit is designed to overcome all the previously mentioned threats, not just while on the moon, but also while working outside the spacecraft, or in the orbit, or sometimes even inside the craft. You would never imagine, but spacesuit gloves are the most limiting factor in the kind of work astronauts can do in space. Although gloves may seem like a simple garment designed to keep our fingers warm, dry, and safe, but fashioning a pair fit for the extremes of space has been a problem, perplexing designers for years. The Apollo program gloves were custom made, built using hands cast of each astronaut. Astronaut gloves are made up of many different layers. The pressure layer keeps air inside the spacesuit. The restraint layer fits over the pressure layer and helps maintain the shape and size of the glove. And finally, a thermal micrometeoroid garment, TMG, layer adds protection against fast-traveling particles and sharp objects. There is no doubt that life as an astronaut involves risks. But who knew those risks come even from wearing spacesuit gloves? The trouble is that gloves, like the entire spacesuit, need to simulate the pressure of Earth's atmosphere. The rigid balloon-like nature of gas-pressurized gloves makes fine motor control a challenge during extravehicular activities. Recent studies found that the fingernail injury is a common problem with astronaut gloves, and that astronauts with bigger hands are more likely to be hurt by their gloves. The injuries most often result from tight gloves that cut off blood flow to the fingertips. Sustained pressure at the fingertips can cause fingernails to break, or in extreme cases, detach from their nail beds or fall off entirely. Ugh. Modern spacesuits have a base pressure garment, along with a complex system of multiple other pieces of equipment and environmental systems designed in a way to keep the wearer comfortable in any surrounding. It also has a self-contained oxygen supply and environmental control system. There are three different types of spacesuits designed for different purposes: IVA, or intravehicular activity suits, EVA, or extravehicular activity suits, and IEVA suits, which serve both purposes. IVA suits are designed to be worn inside a pressurized aircraft, and for which these suits are lightweight and more comfortable. EVA suits, as their name suggests, are suits designed to be worn outside the spacecraft while performing spacewalks or vehicle repairs. These are heavier and protect against the harsh conditions in space. IEVA suits, or intra-extra-vehicular activity suits, are suits that offer the most protection, including protection from micrometeorites and extreme temperature variations. 21st century moonwalkers will be able to accomplish much more complex tasks than their predecessors thanks to strides and technological advances that started even before the Apollo program. The most recent design prototypes include IOTA-X, Mark III, MX-2, PXS, Z-Series, and several other prototypes. The United States intends to send humans to the moon again in 2024 under the Artemis program. Ever since the Apollo program, scientists have wanted to send back more humans for lunar missions, but human-crewed missions are costly, especially for lunar exploration. The Artemis program is going to take the first woman to the moon. The whole program has a budget of $35 billion. 18 astronauts are selected for this mission. The program will make use of two suits, the XEMU, or Exploration Extravehicular Mobility Unit, and OCSS, or Orion Crew Survival System. The former is used on the moon's surface, and it has an endurance of at least 8 hours. It has movable joints and a bearing that would allow waist movement. The audio and microphones are located inside the helmet instead of the traditional Snoopy cap. The OCSS, on the other hand, is to be worn inside the spacecraft during launching and re-entry in case of a depressurized emergency. The outer suit is made orange for visibility in the ocean if astronauts exit the spacecraft without assistance from the recovery panel. The suit is also much more comfortable as it allows free movement, and it's even positively heat resistant. And these suits are expensive and necessary for survival. So if you're ever planning to go for a little walk on the moon, make sure your EVA suit is ready. This brings us to the end of today's episode. Before you leave, do hit the like button and make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also, leave your thoughts in the comments section below. This is Discover X, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.